Hi there, my lovely, lovely sleepy squirrels. I hope that you are all well. Happy New Year. This video is a special little horoscope video to celebrate the new year. Usually I just do these monthly on Patreon, and I just do the signs, the two signs that overlap onto that specific month. But to celebrate Ogmane, I thought it would be nice to do all the signs and shout out all the patrons that have given their birthdays to be included. And talking of birthdays, before we get into the horoscopes, I'm just going to shout out all of my January baby patrons. Starting on the 1st of January, we have two. We have Julie. Hey Julie, happy birthday. And Adriana. Hey Adriana, happy birthday. Hope you both have a lovely, lovely day. Moving on to the 3rd of January, we have Kelsey. You have a lovely day. And on the 4th, we have Manon. Coucou Manon, joyeux anniversaire. J'espère que tu passes une très bonne journée. On to the 5th of January, we have Holly. Hey Holly, happy birthday. Hope you have a lovely day. On the 6th of January, we have two. We have Beth. And Amy. Hey Amy, happy birthday. I hope you two have a lovely, lovely day. On the 8th, we also have two. We have Leah. Hey Leah, happy birthday. And Kimberly. Hey Kimberly, happy birthday. I hope you two have a lovely, lovely day. Moving on to the 14th of January, and we have Charlie. Hey Charlie, happy birthday. Hope you have a lovely, lovely day. On the 15th of January, we have another two. We have Alexandru. Hey Alexandru, happy birthday. And Beth. Hey Beth, happy birthday. I hope you two have a lovely, lovely day. On the 16th, we have Abby. Hey Abby, happy birthday. Hope you have a lovely day. On the 17th, we have Jazz. Hey Jazz, happy birthday. I hope that you have a lovely, lovely day. Moving on to the 24th, we have Ren. Hey Ren, happy birthday. Hope you have a lovely, lovely day. On the 25th, we have Lindsay. Hey Lindsay, happy birthday. I hope you have a lovely, lovely day. And then last but not least, on the 30th of January, we have Alice. Hey Alice, happy birthday. I hope that you have a lovely, lovely day. So let's start this off with our Capricorns. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 Capricorns. We have our December Capricorns. On the 22nd, we have Anya. Hey, Anya. And on the 27th, we have 4 Capricorns. We have Annie. Hey, Annie. Sarah. Hey, Sarah. Georgia. Hey, Georgia. And Fanny. Coucou, Fanny. Then on the 31st of December, we have 3 Capricorns. We have Jess. Hey, Jess. Anna. Hey, Anna. And Jessica. And if I'm not mistaken, that is the Jessica that shared with us that she turned 50. So, happy 50th, Jessica. Hope you had a lovely, lovely day. It looked like And then on to the January Capricorns. On the 1st, we have Julie. Hey, Julie. And Adriana. Hey, Adriana. On the 3rd, we have Kelsey. Hey, Kelsey. On the 4th, we have Manon. Coucou, Manon. On the 5th, we have Holly. Hey, Holly. On the 6th, we have Beth. Hey, Beth. And Amy. Hey, Amy. On the 8th, we have Leah. Hey, Leah. And Kimberly. Hey, Kimberly. Then on the 14th, we have Charlie. Hey, Charlie. On the 15th, we have Alexandru. Hey, Alexandru. And Beth. Hey, Beth. On the 16th, we have Abby. Hey, Abby. And last but not least, we have Jazz on the 17th. So this is especially for you, 22. And of course, all the other Capricorns out there. Bring on the New Year energy. 2024 gets off to a positive start when Mercury resumes direct motion in your healing zone on the 2nd of January. Where one door closes, another really does open. Get ready to shake it off and shine brighter than ever. A new moon in your sign on the 11th of January offers the perfect opportunity to power up your goals for the year ahead. Know that if you've been waiting for your big moment in the spotlight, it's closer than ever now. Aquarius season sees the sun hone in on your finances from the 20th of January, joined by planet of rebirth Pluto the day after. This is the beginning of a big change of fortune for you. Trust your instincts, continue to innovate, and make sure the people you surround yourself with have got your back. A pileup of planets in your sign, plus a full moon in your transformation zone, on the 25th of January, hammers home one decisive message. Your future starts now. End the month on a high by putting yourself out there in a major way. Break convention. It's time to become the best ever version of you. And if you're feeling a little extra, you could try some breath work for deep relaxation. And your mantra for the month is go for it. Go for it. So now on to Aquarius. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 Aquarius patrons. Starting with the January Aquariuses. On the 24th, we have Ren. Hey, Ren. On the 25th, we have Lindsay. And on the 30th, we have Alice. Hey, Alice. And on to the February Aquariuses. On the 1st of February, we have Isabel. Hey, Isabel. On the 6th, we have Grace. Hey, Grace. On the 8th, we have Milana. Hey, Milana. And on the 9th, we have Vandala. Moving on to the 13th, we have Leo. Hey, Leo. On the 14th, we have Laura. Hey, Laura. On the 15th, we have Sydney. Hey, Sydney. And last but not least, on the 17th, we have Paige. Hey, Paige. This is especially for you, 11, and of course, all the other Aquariuses out there. the party doesn't have to end yet. We see you clinging onto those sequins for dear life. But you won't be able to escape the reality of 2024 forever. Capricorn season brings themes of healing and closure your way. And this time, it's the big stuff you're dealing with. It's time to face a few truths as the year begins. The 11th of January's new moon urges you to acknowledge your own role in a tricky relationship and seek positive ways to move forward. Leave your anger behind and know that you've got this. When the sun enters your sign on the 20th of January, closely followed by rebirth planet Pluto, you'll be more than ready to forgive, forget, and move on. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your relationship zone, urging you to prioritize a significant other. And whether a friendship, business connection, or love interest is springing to mind when you read that, know that you are better together than apart. Your home and family life is changing and evolving into something more magical than you could imagine. Go with the flow on this one. If you are feeling a little extra, you could book an outdoor sauna session. Ooh, fancy. And your mantra for this month is change is good. Change. So now on to Pisces. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 12 Pisces patrons. On the 1st of March, we have Katie. Hey, Katie. And Nat. Hey, Nat. On the 3rd of March, we have Elijah, and Emily. Hey, Emily. On the 4th of March, we have Carly. Hey, Carly. Amanda. Hey, Amanda. And Jennifer. Hey, Jennifer. On the 6th of March, we have Becca. Hey, Becca. And on the 8th, we have Mirandia. Hey, Mirandia. On the 10th of March, we have Saul. Hey, Saul. And the 13th, we have Emma. Hey, Emma. And last but not least, on the 20th of March, we have Mayra. Hey, Mayra. And this is especially for you 12, but also for all of those Pisces out there. Start 2024 as you mean to go on. This year is set to be a big one for you, and that means hitting the ground running with a goal or idea. Mercury direct in your success zone from the 2nd of January gets things off to a positive start, while the 11th of January's new moon invites you to call in new connections and opportunities. One thing is certain, there will be no fading into the background for Pisces in 2024. Except to make progress on a writing, speaking, or creative project from the off this month. Just take care not to burn yourself out. Aquarius season begins on the 20th of January with emphasis on your healing zone, reminding you to stay on track with a health or well-being plan, a lifestyle change you implement this month could make a huge difference going forwards, so don't quit at the first hurdle. By the 25th of January's full moon, you'll be ready to start work on a dream project. You've waited a lifetime for a moment like this. And if you're feeling a little extra, you could double up on yoga or meditation all month long. And your mantra for the month is start as you mean to go on. Start as you mean to go on. Okay, so now on to Aries. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 Aries. The March Aries, we have Jan on the 22nd. Hey Jan. Carol on the 23rd. Hey Carol. On the 27th, we have Laurie. Hey Laurie. And on the 29th, we have Dulcie. Moving on to the April Aries, on the 2nd of April, we have Sarah. Hey Sarah. On the 3rd, we have Tony. Hey Tony. On the 7th, we have Emma. Hey Emma. And Annie. Hey Annie. On the 8th of April, we have Mary. Hey Mary. And on the 12th, we have Tara. Hey, Tara. On the 14th, we have Jill. Hey, Jill. On the 18th, we have Louisa. Hey, Louisa. And on the 19th, last but not least, we have two. We have Victoria. Hey, Victoria. And Sadie. Hey, Sadie. This is especially for you 15, and of course for all the other Aries out there. Be ready to knuckle down and put a plan into action as 2024 begins. There will be no lack of January inspiration if the cosmos gets its way. So make the most of the good vibes while you can. Ready to level up in your career? A wildest dream opportunity could be headed your way this month. Expect more out of life, and that's exactly what you'll get in 2024. The 11th of January's new moon invites you to think big when it comes to your future. Find someone who inspires you and follow their lead. Aquarius season brings exciting opportunities your way, just as long as you're willing to put yourself out there. Resist the urge to hibernate and accept an offer from someone intriguing. A meeting of minds could send your career stratospheric if you play your cards right. Your self-worth has come a long way in the last few years, so make sure it stays that way this month. Treat yourself, invest in yourself, and don't settle for less. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your fame zone, bringing positive attention when you need it most. Your star is rising. And if you are feeling a little extra this month, you could invest in a 2024 journal and write daily. Your mantra for the month is share your story. Share. Now on to Taurus. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Taurus patrons. On the 24th of April, we have Teresa. Hey, Teresa. On the 28th, we have Georgie. Hey, Georgie. And on the 30th, we have Eduarda. Hey, Eduarda. And in May, we have Beth on the 6th. Hey, Beth. We have Lemonly on the 7th. Hey, Lemonly. Lovely name. On the 14th of May, we have Emma. Hey, Emma. And on the 19th, we have Blue. Hey, Blue. This is especially for E7. And of course, for all. One thing is certain, life is going to look completely different for you by the end of 2024, and it all starts now. Find a way to embrace a big change you feel unsure about, and you'll soon see exactly why things had to be this way. The 11th of January's new moon invites you to expand your mind beyond the here and now and set your sights on something bigger. You can achieve anything you set your mind to. Aquarius season brings a sense of urgency to your work life as you navigate a lifestyle change. Put your creative mind to work because there's an untapped resource out there somewhere. And you're one step away from discovering it. A new way to solve an old problem could change everything this month. Life might feel complicated right now, but the stability you need is coming. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your domestic fourth house, urging you to allow someone to show up for you in the most magical way. Accept help, release negativity, flow into your future. By the end of the month, you'll feel ready for what lies ahead. And if you're feeling a little extra, you could try an acupressure mat for intense relaxation. I bought one of those guys. Your mantra for the month is trust the process. Trust the process. Okay. So on to the Geminis. And we have 14 Geminis. On the 21st of May, we have Kelly. Hey, Kelly. On the 24th, we have Cheryl. Hey, Cheryl. And Samantha. Hey, Samantha. And on the 28th of May, we have Lindsay. Hey, Lindsay. On to the June Geminis. On the 2nd of June, we have Emma. Hey, Emma. On the 7th of June, we have Danielle. Hey, Danielle. And on the 8th, we have Kelly. Hey, Kelly. On the 12th, we have Luca. Hey, Luca. And on the 13th, we have Stephanie. Hey, Stephanie. And on the 17th of June, we have Paige. Hey, Paige. And Hannah. Hey, Hannah. And last but not least, we have two. On the 19th of June, we have Katie. Hey, Katie. And Amanda. Hey, Amanda. This is especially for E13. Glad to see the back of 2023. We feel you. You've come a long way since this time last year, and things are finally looking up. Trust your intuition and a new flirtation or love affair, and ask for more of what you want this time. The 11th of January's new moon falls in your transformation zone to inspire you to take the new you to the next level. You've soft launched Gemini 2.0, but the world is ready for the next big reveal. Aquarius season brings optimism and inspiration your way from the 20th of January as a bright idea begins to take off. When change maker Pluto hits up your healing zone on the 21st of January, you'll know you're on the right path. Embrace your spiritual side as you navigate the challenges ahead this year. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your communication zone, sprinkling the right kind of magic on a writing or speaking project. Believe in your ability to gather a crowd and say what needs to be said. The truth might hurt, but it will also set you free. A career goal that once felt like a stretch to you is finally within reach. And if you're feeling a little extra, you could write a wish list to the universe. And your mantra for the month is let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Okay. So on to the Cancers. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 Cancers. In June, on the 24th, we have Heather, hey Heather, and G, hey G. On the 25th, we have Sandra, hey Sandra. On the 26th, we have Janine, hey Janine. On the 27th, we have Sarah, hey Sarah. And on the 29th, we have Nathan, hey Nathan. On to the July Cancers. On the 6th, we have Heather, another Heather, hey Heather. On the 7th, we have Michelle, hey Michelle. On the 11th, we have Susie, hey Susie. On the 13th, we have Sarah, hey Sarah. On the 14th, we have Katie, hey Katie. And last but not least, on the 20th, this is especially for you 12, and of course all the other Cancers out there. Don't put off a January health kick just because it feels cliche. It's cliche for a reason. And with Mercury direct in your wellness zone from the 2nd of January, now is the perfect time to make a lifestyle change. A shake-up elsewhere in your life could also be in order. Capricorn season, along with the 11th of January's new moon, puts your closest relationships under scrutiny. There's not much you wouldn't do to make your people happy, but take care to consider your own feelings about a certain new beginning. Time with friends who understand what you're dealing with is invaluable right now. Remember, you don't have to pretend everything is perfect. Aquarius season begins on the 20th of January, bringing intense feelings and personal change your way. Who do you really want to be? What do you really want your life to look like? There's no shame in wanting more. This might just be the beginning of a magical new adventure for you. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your money zone to remind you that you have more power than you realize. Trust your instincts and know you have the talent to back up an idea. And if you are feeling a little extra, you could make a vision board for the year ahead. And your mantra for the month. Forgive and forget. Now on to the Leos. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 Leos, 14 counting me. On the 24th of July, we have Warwick. On the 25th, we have 3 lovely patrons. We have Laura. Hey, Laura. Alan. Hey, Alan. And Amanda. Hey, Amanda. And on the 30th of July, we have Liz. Hey, Liz. And into August, on the 2nd, we have Sarah. Hey, Sarah. On the 4th, we have Issy. On the 5th, we have Allie. Hey, Allie. On the 8th, we have Jenny. Hey, Jenny. And myself, Amy. On the 9th, we have Michelle. Hey, Michelle. On the 15th, we have Alyssa. Hey, Alyssa. On the 19th, we have Abby. And last but not least, on the 22nd of August, we have Jess. Hey, Jess. This is especially for you 13 and all the other Leos out there. It's all change in Leo world this January. If you've been waiting for the right time to implement a change in your daily routine, work, or wellness, that time has come. Capricorn season homes in on your sixth house, urging you to shake things up, start over, and really commit to doing things differently. A well-being goal set on the 11th of January's new moon could bring the change you've been longing for. Just do it. Once one thing falls into place, the rest will follow. Expect good news in your career and relationships before the end of the month. Cool. Aquarius season arrives with a bang on the 20th of January to remind you that you can't do any of this alone. Focus in on the people who feel like part of your team. And make sure they know how much they matter to you. A new way of looking at a romantic relationship could make all the difference in 2024. Perhaps your differences are strengths in disguise. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your sign and invites you to leave an old version of yourself behind. A magical new world awaits you if you choose to take the first step. If you are feeling a little extra, you could take a daily nature walk for maximum magic. And your mantra for the month is listen more. So now onto the And we have 19 Virgos. That's a lot, guys. Okay, so starting in August, on the 25th, we have three patrons. We have CZ. Hey, CZ. We have Mandy. Hey, Mandy. And we have Charlotte. Hey, Charlotte. On the 28th, we have Claire. And then on to September, Virgos. On the 2nd, we have Elk. Hey, Elk. On the 3rd, we have Annie. Hey, Annie. And we have Kelly. Hey, Kelly. On the 4th, we have Katie. Hey, Katie. On the 7th, we have Valerie. Cuckoo, Valerie. On the 9th, we have Rachel. Hey, Rachel. On the 12th, we have Jennifer. Hey, Jennifer. And on the 13th, we have Sam. Hey, Sam. And Steph. Hey, Steph. On the 15th of September, we have Cynthia. Hey, Cynthia. On the 16th of September, we have Amy. Hey, Amy. And on the 18th of September, we have Anissa. Hey, Anissa. And on the 19th, we have Jess. Hey, Jess. And last but not least, on the 21st of September, we have Michelle. Hey, Michelle. So this is especially for you 19, and of course, for all the other Virgos out there. Feeling fired up and ready for action? That's the spirit. It's good vibes from the off this January. Thanks to Mercury direct in your creative fifth house. Use the first few days of the month to get clear on your big idea before your inbox gets full again. You're going places in 2024, and this is a big one. The 11th of January's new moon invites you to commit to a project right here and right now. No more excuses or putting it off. Get going now and everything will fall into place in February. When the Sun enters Aquarius on the 20th of January, you'll be ready to double down on efforts at work and in your personal life. You've tried and failed and tried and been derailed before, but this time it's different. Keep going with anything that prioritizes your health or future goals. Your world is about to expand beyond anything you've previously dreamt up for yourself. So be ready to go with the flow. The 25th of January's full moon invites you to recommit to letting go of an unhealthy habit you know has been holding you back. It's your time to shine. Wow, that's a really good one, guys. If you're feeling a little extra, you could plan in some proper time. Sounds like the opposite of what I just said, but okay. And your mantra for the month is own your magic. Own your magic. Okay. So now on to Libra. And we have a 17 Libra patrons. Starting on September the 24th, we have Carrie. Hey, Carrie. On the 26th, we have Janice. Hey, Janice. On the 27th, we have Priscilla. On the 28th, we have Raquel. Hey, Raquel. And on the 30th of September, we have Rob. Hey, Rob. On to the October Libras. On the 1st of October, we have Mel. Cuckoo Mel. On the 8th of October, we have Kim. Hey, Kim. On the 12th, we have Frederick. And on the 13th of October, we have three patrons. We have Caitlin. Hey, Caitlin. We have Sally. Hey, Sally. And we have Estefany. Hey, Estefany. On the 15th of October, we have Jinsia. Hey, Jinsia. On the 16th, we have Tracy. Hey, Tracy. On the 17th, we have Kelly. Hey, Kelly. And on the 18th, we have Maddie. Hey, Maddie. And Victoria. Hey, Victoria. And last but not least, on the 23rd of October, we have Peyton. Hey, Peyton. So this is especially for E16 and, of course, all the you might want to firm up your foundations and assemble a team of cheerleaders as 2024 begins. This is an important month for you, and you'll need systems in place to support your goals. Create a plan that prioritizes all of this on the 11th of January's new moon. And you'll soon see the magic that happens when you put yourself first for a change. Do what feels right, and this could be your most life-changing year yet. Aquarius season brings good vibes your way from the 20th of January as a creative idea gets a green light. Who knew life and work could be this much fun? You're about to find out. When the full moon beams into your social zone on the 25th of January, you could be faced with a thrilling new opportunity. Forget everything that's gone before and focus on what's right in front of you. Stay strong, and you can have everything you dream of before the year is out. The month ends with a reminder to prioritize your health at all costs. You didn't come this far to only come this far. If you're feeling a little extra, you could light white candles for inner peace on the new moon. And your mantra for the month is face the music. Face the music. Okay. So on to the Scorpios. And we have 11 Scorpios. 3 in 26th of October, we have Rachel. Hey, Rachel. On the 28th, we have Emmanuel. Coucou, Emmanuel. And on the 29th, we have Melissa. Hey, Melissa. On to November. On the 1st, we have Sarah. Hey, Sarah. The lovely Sarah that drew the illustration of the sleepy squirrel. On the 2nd of November, we have Safia. Hey, Safia. On the 7th, we have Alexa. Hey, Alexa. On the 10th, we have Stephanie. Hey, Stephanie. On the 11th, we have Sam. Hey, Sam. On the 12th, we have Jessica. On the 14th, we have Ali. Hey, Ali. And last but not least, on the 18th of November, we have Kimberly. Hey, Kimberly. This is especially for you, 11, and of course, all of the other Scorpios out there. The truth will set you free in your 2024 horoscope. Saying something that needs to be said might feel intimidating at first, especially for secretive Scorpions. But the payoff will be worth it. The world is ready to hear more of your voice, and now is the perfect time to get started. If you've ever thought about writing a book, hosting a big event, or taking center stage, make a wish on the 11th of January's new moon. Anything is possible if you play your cards right from the off this month. By Aquarius season, you'll be ready to take things down a notch as you get to work on your masterpiece. More time at home doesn't have to be boring. Hunker down, perfect your craft, and be ready to emerge victorious in a few weeks' time. Be careful not to neglect your love life. There's magic in the air for you and a certain someone, just as long as you're willing to give them a chance. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your success zone and urges you to ignore your inner critic when it comes to a dream. It's not too out there. You can make it happen. Get started, and you'll soon see a sign you're on the right track. If you are feeling a little extra, you could book a spot on a retreat and work out the logistics later. That's very spontaneous and expensive, probably. Your mantra for the month is create. So now on to Sagittarius, and we have 14 Sagittarius patrons. Starting in November, on the 23rd, we have Cassandra. Hey, Cassandra. On the 25th, we have Mary. Hey, Mary. On the 28th, we have Taylor. Hey, Taylor. And on the 30th, we have Kristen. Hey, Kristen. On to December, on the 1st, we have Monica. Hey, Monica. On the 3rd, we have Jorinda. Hey, Jorinda. On the 5th, we have Natasha. Hey, Natasha. On the 6th, we have Jenny. Hey, Jenny. On the 9th, we have Hannah. Hey, Hannah. And on the 13th, we have Rachel. Hey, Rachel. And Georgina. Hey, Georgina. On the 17th, we have Olivia. Hey, Olivia. On the 18th, we have Jess. Hey, Jess. And last but not least, on the 20th of December, we have Tanya. Hey, Tanya. This is especially for E14 and, of course, all the other Sagittarius out there. Take a deep breath and remember who you are. You'll need all the optimism you can muster to hit the ground running this January. But the cosmos has got your back. Explore your creative side, commit to hard work, and know that everything related to sharing a cause or story looks lit for you in the year to come. Use the power of the 11th of January, new moon, to set a bold financial goal. Just because you're following your heart on this one doesn't mean you have to become a starving artist. Aquarius season brings big conversations and big ideas to the table from the 20th of January. So don't shy away from difficult questions. You might not know quite where all this is going, but it's important to have your own back. Keep your work-life balance in check, and you'll end the month feeling more empowered and positive about the future. The 25th of January's full moon falls in your expansive 9th house, urging you to learn more, share more, and explore more as the month progresses. Do what lights you up and trust that every step forwards is a step in the right direction. If you are feeling a little extra, you could invest in a card reading for the year ahead. And your mantra for the month is keep. So that is everyone. Hopefully I didn't miss anyone. Let me know in the comments if any of that sounds good to you. If it kind of clicks in with what's going on in your life in January, let me know. It's just a bit of fun, guys. Let me know. And of course, if you are already a patron and you would like to be included for the next months and etc., just pop your birthday into the pinned post on Patreon. And if you are not yet a patron, that's fine. You don't have to. But if you would like to be involved in this kind of thing and more personalized content, it's always linked in the description. Okay. So, I hope that you enjoyed this video. The blanket scratching, the soft-spoken whisper, the fun horoscope chat. I hope that every single one of my sleepy squirrels, wherever you are in the world, whatever's happening around you, I hope that you can find your own little bubble of calm. For example, if you are in Northern Ireland, like my lovely, lovely patron, thank you for all of your lovely, lovely support. Ellen is a fellow Leo. I hope you liked our horoscope this month. And I hope that you all have a lovely, lovely, lovely evening. Happy New Year, guys. And I'll see you.